back to Abend Today, the most amazing show that you definitely want to be part of every morning before you do step out to look for that money. T7, and I do hope your coffee is ready in your hands. And now, being a Wednesday, we usually like to flip pages to the relationship side. Now, this morning, we'll be talking about some key things that any single person out there should have in their life. This is a must. If you don't have any of these things, I suggest you do find all possible ways to look for them, because your life could depend on it. Being single is not easy, especially in this day and age, understanding that everyone will be up and about the moon, talking about their plans for Valentine's. For us, the single people, or for you, the single people, this is what you need to have. You have been single
forever, and I love it. Oh boy, do I love
it. I am still talking. You have been single.
No, I am single.
You have been single. Even single. The single relationship itself is tired of you.
I'm in a relationship with my singleness.
When is dating?
We do not know.
You have been single from 6:30 when you left your home.
Yes.
Up to now. Tell us about those things that you have with you from 6:30.
Can
up
I turn
to
the dance now?
You
have been single from the last person you talked to on your phone, but let us
know. Anyway, let's have this conversation on the road.
First thing, like everybody, like they asked me when I had my breakup, which I'm not embarrassed about. Things don't work out. No one should be embarrassed about
having a breakup.
At times, things don't work out. So when I broke up, I'm lucky. I have three kids. You know, I have three kids. I have eight dogs, and the biggest question everyone used to ask me, how are you going to live alone in a house with just your kids? I was like, I am single, not inadequate. But the things I have learned, every single person needs to have. Number one on my rule list of things you should have, please have a panga, a baseball bat, a knife, a gun, and dogs. That's rule number one.
Okay.
Of living single. Rule number two for me, have a vice. Have a vice that takes all your singleness away from you. It could be reading, it could be alcohol, it could be whatever it is. I mean, pick a vice, because at some point we all have a vice. Once you have a vice, it helps you not concentrate on the fact that you are alone. And you put the energies into something else.
Which is very dangerous.
Because of course.
You might die alone.
I want to be alone. Let me die alone.
What's up, man? I can't find sleep. Status update.
But that's the beauty of being single. That when I put up such a status update and I can't find sleep, there's way too many people who want to soothe me into sleep.
Listen.
Because I noticed, as human beings, we think we can fix people. That's our problem. Moving into situations and thinking we can fix people. You can't fix a person. If I'm broken, if I'm damaged, if I am what I am, let me walk through that. Let me fix my damage. Let me fix my broken. So,
being single is beautiful. First of all, whether you're single or not, you need, you know, the side you like to face when you're sleeping. We all have that side where we are comfortable. Just under the bed, you have to have a road that is probably this side.
Of course.
I don't know how they say that in English.
Smart card.
Even if you smart card at night, your hand can reach and you can defend yourself.
The problem is if when you try to reach and the person who came to do whatever they did was stronger than you.
No, unless they probably dragged you through the windows. But if someone broke into your house, you would hear them. So you have to have something you can reach when you're sleeping at night
to defend yourself
just close by, and then also you have to have a trick on your door that can alert you even when you're deep in sleep. Either there's a way you have to lock your door, chimes or something.
I tell people get chimes. When I just moved out of my father's house and I was terrified of the house that I moved into.
Make it 40. Let's continue with the story.
I would get empty wine bottles and hang them up on the door, so that in case anyone walks in, the bottles are going to fall, and you will definitely hear those bottles. So I would line them up. Those are simple hacks. You know, if you can't, you can get a chime at the door. Or if you are one of them who has money, you can always invest in a motion sensor.
Onta no kwata ebi kola. You know dry leaves. Mm.
And throw them in front of your door.
You throw them at the window of your bedroom.
Go. I like
whenever
that.
Someone is walking, you hear.
Okay, now I have a better one. That one is not scary. Banan, get you some white Johnson powder. Now this one I learned it works. Mm-hmm. Get you like white Johnson powder, mix it in ash, get you a calabash, get you a pot. Every night before you go to sleep, put your calabash, line it out with like make a circle, put a calabash in, put a broom on the side. Basically, just juju, look it up. Put that on your door, put that on your windows. No, mubi teri mubi mu Africa. Ah, tati adogo.
Na yeye ndiye mubi tati adogo. Na ndiye agenda kutoka gwe. Ndikumuni na. Bitu ile mbije mwa malala.
People.
Ndio intention baby powder, ndio ina calabash, ina broom. Na ndiye ya kugobela yesterday.
Ndio kucha na.
Ndikumuni na.
Ah. People,
yeah, people thought that that's a joke. I was passing through Chariwajara sometime. Ngamune ndaba akamoro kaka stalit. Ngagaya has done exactly that thing.
Trust the one that was on social.
No. It's a different one. Kwa nukali kawaiti.
Ngakata deko
kawaiti. Alikuwa kalabashi ye waguru. Ngadi spraying a navy, subi, what. Not, I saw this thing. And in my mind, I knew it was a joke.
Uganda.
But when I saw it, I
was like,
I saw it as like, Chitumfo na eka ine doge ya dara. Chinzoba it was a joke, but chino chinzoba it dara.
So but you know, what's the first thing that walks you, like that goes through your mind? When you walk, like, let's say you're going to visit Derek, like at 7 in the night, right? And then you get to Derek's doorstep, and there's a mound of soil. They are like olive leaves put together. And then to make, if you really want to make it like very, very scary, right? Kwate, yo yabi enkoku. Now you have it or be mixing
imagine man, they raped a chick at 5 a.m.
And that's very sad. But I think the change of
the world is very bad.
And at the end of that day, we know we do be a quota. So now let's talk about more practical things. That was very
practical. A more practical one, if you're single and staying absolutely alone.
Like the two of you.
Yeah, and you have a formula for yourself. You know, when people come to your house, they're supposed to call you first.
Yes.
A more practical.
Yes.
If you don't believe in the juju setup and making it look like juju, please have a hot wire. You connect on your door hinge.
Oh, I saw someone who did that.
Hold it. What do you mean a hot
get
wire?
An electric wire. Let me explain. Get an electric hot wire.
You shock someone to death.
That's the point.
Hey, why are you coming to my house if you didn't?
Unannounced,
guys. That's attempted murder.
No!
No!
You tried to kill someone. That is trespass.
It is a trespass.
When you come and you didn't call me or text me,
don't connect it on that door. Connect it on the handle.
No. Now I know a family where I was living. Basoka ne baba gwasoka. So they first connected that whole thing that you're talking about with the handle. Rubber gloves. So the next time he told his son, they hot wired all the windows. And funny things that there are kids in that house, but everyone knows. Now this is what killed me. After he did that for a week, no thieves came. Like muja kujamba money. 2 weeks into it, these idiots came at my judge course. If you're single, hot wiring is very easy.
Just connect it to a
guys, socket. That's attempted murder.
We just switch it on.
Wait.
Go away, Waka.
First, wait. Why is this idiot feeling sorry for the same people who would beat you up.
I'm not. If you are single, invest time in yourself, banange. Let me explain my point. If you're single, make your kamane. Spoil for yourself. Take yourself out. Where you got a konga?
You see, Eric, you need to understand that every man is a pretty boy. Not everyone is.
No, this is not. This is not a pretty boy syndrome. This is anyone can do. Even Willis can do this. You get.
But I do this all the time.
Even Farouk can do this.
I do this all the time.
Actually, I'm giving you the unpretty boy situation.
What are you talking about?
Sit in your car, drive, go to Jinja, look at the falls, you know, do some bungee jumping, have some good time. Have a good time. Being single is a problem, I'm telling you, especially in Uganda. And if you're poor, that is the worst thing to ever do.
Also, the other thing to have when you're single, you either have to have a cat or a dog.
You need them.
Not you may choose to have
for security.
The indoor cat and dog, not the big ones that require a lot of maintenance.
Pets.
You can have like a little Maltese or a cat, or you can have like a little pug. Just like a dog to bark around to notify you into your zone or tazeki. Also, wobango li singo, nenga tobe na mchibuga. You stay Liantonde, Arua Munde, Namayingo district. You're single, maybe you rent in Yoka village, but you can, you know, start, you're watching us right now in the morning. Watch a jidita. Zisale, ziseke kuruji. Kubamu awali singo, if you're single in that part of the country, you face different problems from us in the city. In the city, tuwa nawabi. Mucharo, you are uncomfortable because we have a
abalogo.
Take a jirita kuruji.
And what have you decided?
Oh, yeah, jiggy, zi. Kumachora, right? I'm bulobu.
Linda, go. Back on you.
What do you want to do? Right, I'm bulobu.
Now, then you're not going to be
today. Wabali up country, Akina, Ruwa, Gulu, and all these places, in light of what he has said, Bana Bamu never says a one way. It looks like a sugar cane, but it's not really a sugar cane.
What is that?
It's fine, a sugar cane.
Porcupine.
Yeah, porcupine. That's an animal.
I just came out with the word.
Baruko kateke de wama. Gweba kubiso msezi. Mkobo msanganga abuka bukandu kayera rusa. Ochimukuba mnundi kumuto mbu wakoma.
Mboko.
Mbu wakoma wo. Tada mukuogera mpaka kumachange kitambo chigeze
This one is like one of the most important thing in the village. If you're watching from Soroti and you're single, you usually walk to the towns and have a blast and come back home like at midnight alone. That you fear, you know, on the road. If you are seeing one, usually walk around or drive your bicycle alone, please walk while you make many voices. Hello.
Hello.
How are
you?
Where were you?
I'm Jeff. I'm watching.
Come in. Kola Maroba Singo Tamlo Kvamutown, up to when to get to your place. Because when they hear you making voices, they'll think you're many.
Now you're not going to buy this
country.
I'm Do we have any strange but true facts this morning? If you do have them, please let me have them on the screens. Yes, and the first is that so right there is that a group of pandas is actually called an embarrassment. So apparently, why you being an embarrassment? Next is that guys at their mathematical best when a girl says she's pregnant.
Oh, they know the numbers. Yeah, they crunch them real quick.
That's very true.
Oh, they crunch them. I've had three babies.
You've told someone.
I've had three babies. They will crunch the numbers. Eh? Guy Omugamba, I am pregnant now. Mm. All of a sudden, he becomes like that guy in the series Numbers. He's like, well, if you get X minus 5, then you put my salary minus my father's men. Well, in a year, I'll be earning about 600,000. No, you know what? You need to
avoid it. That is equation 1. You know, in mathematics, they used to give us equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. So, no matter about equation 2. If I call Dr. Sam, and then I tell him that I have a small somebody. How about today, guys? In a very quick break, but when we do get back, we'll be talking more, especially in the world of sports. You definitely have to keep it right here with us. Welcome back from that short break. And of course, it's time for sport this morning. But a little bit of a reminder, if you get over to our social media page, we do have a relationship question for you. One of some peeps that did get in touch with us, going by the names of Lucy, is having a kind of confusing relationship whereby, she still has feelings for her ex. And then on the other hand, her current boyfriend was on having plans to propose. Now, we're asking you, what advice do you have for Lucy? She's saying she's a little bit confused. I'll get into more of the details later on at about 7:30 and give you exactly where this story is coming on from. But this morning, it is Sports This Morning by Nicholas. Good morning to you.
Morning. Lucy needs to move on, my friend. You know these things. We fall in love and fall out of love. And if you fall out and you've left part of your feelings the other side, and I think you need to go back and try and, mend things up. It's like your ex coming at your place. Chances are that you'll have sex with her, because then there's always that little attachment that you guys have a history. But nevertheless, I think Lucy needs to move on real quick before she gets damage control from inside out. But it's still, I don't speak from experience. I speak from
basic knowledge. The sixth sense
applied in itself.
UPL looking at an interesting game coming in from Nyamchogora. These games seem to be getting their way back into the winning ways. They were playing Police FC yesterday, and they managed to move on with a victory, 4-1.
A very rare win, if you ask me, for Nyamchogora, based on the fact that they've been struggling for results in the last 6 or 7 matches. Yesterday, they pounced on a very poor side in Police FC, who registered their 7th defeat of the season, dropping to 9th on the log. For me, these are worrying signs for the Cops in Police FC. And for Nyamitobara, the guests, I thought they deserved that win on match day 16. Not the perfect start in the second stanza for Abdallah Mubiru and his men. But the man there in Juma Dada, he was a nightmare. That's, of course, the shot number 9. He was a nightmare for Police FC's backline. He tormented them right from the first whistle. And that hard work paid off against the host in Police FC, who managed to pull one back later on from Gariwa, which was nothing but a consolation. Maximum points for the side in Nyamitobara. Of course, that result didn't really do much for them, because they stayed in the relegation zone. And this is how horrible they've been. That is, in Nyamitobara, they, of course, managed to register their third win of the season. And for Asaf Mwebaze, you start to feel that this could be the start of many good days at the club side in Nyamitobara. Of course, we talked about the unveiling of 8 new players, licenses being availed on time. And if Ben Minsaga can stay out of manager's business, then I think the club side will go on to survive the axe at the end of the season. But better yet still, it was a very good game, or very good outing for the guests, and it was glad. It was sigh of relief from Asaf Mwebaze, who succeeded James Odoch, having been sacked. But in Toro, it was again Waspo Bosses men who actually had the final say. They left it late against Express FC, getting that slim victory against Bukwano Gwabanj. And for me, this is not what Kefa Kisala had planned, because then after the five new signings just the other day, with of course players being unveiled at Wankulu Kuku, this result says a lot about what Toro United bring on table, especially after mixed campaign in the first round. But their third successive league win, that's for Toro United of Waswa Bosser, fourth in all competition, of course, including the game, the win against KCCFC. For Express FC, who began the day seventh on the log, that defeat right there at the Wahinga Stadium took them down to eighth position. And quite the games yesterday in the Uganda Premier League. A very, very good win for Nyamitobara and a very slim victory for Toro United against Express FC.
Looking at the performance coming in from Nyamitobara, we all know they have struggled for form. And if anything, if games kept on being lost, they would be relegated back to the big league. Do we see them having a sustainable position?
I tell you what,
as far as the EPL is concerned,
if they can continue putting in shifts like the one they put in yesterday against Police FC, without a doubt, they will survive the relegation. But what we saw in the first round is a team that can't create, a team that can't defend. And if you can't have those two elements in your team, then you're bound to be given the axe, and you don't deserve to play in the top flight. But what Asaf Mwebaze is doing at the moment, because Nyamitobara having lost a few big names in there, that is why they had to recruit just the other day. When you look at this side, it's not the strongest of sides, but I do believe there's so much raw talent in there that just needs a little bit of polishing for them to get back to winning ways. It was a very huge win for them against a relatively good side, but on the day in Police FC, they sometimes show up and then tend not to show up, and yesterday they just didn't show up at all and got a very good hammering against Nyamitobara. But like I said, it's a huge win, and if they continue putting in decent shifts like the one they had yesterday, then they should be in cloud nine and survive relegation at the end of the season.
Still looking at the UPL, we do have the Ankole Lions back in
position.
Bara FC, that is of course up against the wounded KCC after they did lose their game.
Talk about a scenario when you go to someone's home and you know you're uninvited, but somehow you want to be invited. That's a situation that will be happening this afternoon with KCC FC. We know for sure KCC FC will be hungry to get maximum points against the Ankole Lions. It's a game they need to win. But bearing in mind that Mbara City have been quite the team in the first round, they've been very, very resilient, and they've proven to the other big oppositions they're here to stay, and they made a very clear statement after finishing third in the Uganda Premier League. But it's a good game. A lineup this afternoon at the Kachaka Stadium, not the best of places for Mike Mutebi and his men. Of course, for KCFC, they are without their manager in Mike Mutebi, having been banned by FUFA after very controversial statements about how the club side have a side budget to fix matches. But I bet yet still this afternoon, I think Mbara City might just go out there and frustrate the Kasasiro boys, because they have every right to believe to win this game, knowing that KCCFC will be coming all guns blazing, because then 3 points at stake, 5 points clear at the top of the UPL. A slight drop today will put Vipers back in contention in regards to the title race. But what Mbabazi Livingston has built over the last 6 months or so, the signing of Paul Mucherezi, of course there will be a reunion between Paul Mucherezi and his former side in KCCFC. The signing of Paul Mucherezi has been quite influential. This has had immediate impact on the club in Mbara City, and currently third. To win today would actually take that tally to 4 games and actually 6 games unbeaten in the domestic league. What a game to look forward to. And for Mike Mutebi, I know at the back of his mind, having lost out in his last 2 trips at the Kacheka Stadium, he can't afford to draw points today against the Ankole Lions, who await the Kasasiro boys, the 12-time UPL champions. Down in Jinja, we have Bull FC set to rub shoulders against Maroons FC. Of course, for Maroons FC, they will be starting life without their coach in George Besson Simbe. We understand he's leaving for Tanzania for a course program, and we expect our former Uganda Cranes forward in David Oboa to take care of business temporarily until the club side in Maroons have a permanent a person for this particular role. But yeah, Maroons away to Bull FC, Mbara City at home against KCCF today in the Uganda.
Does that mean that Mike Mutebi is not traveling to Kacheka?
I think he will, but he will be watching from the stands.
He can travel with the team, but he's
not allowed to be on the touch. touch line. Yeah, you know, just so Molly Wekwaso will be the man in charge to you know, pass on the instructions. But this is a game that they need to win.
So Mukabi can yell instructions.
He's always been yelling, you know, throwing arms and punching the air. He's an agitated man, by the way. You rarely see him smile. Maybe when there's a nice, you know, spectacular, well-crafted goal that has been scored. Jackson Nuno usually scores that. That's when you see the smile on his face. But he's a man of five colors. He's a man of so many colors. Today he's happy, tomorrow he's not. Today he's agitated, tomorrow he's a bit off. So for Mike Mutebi, I think the players won't miss him.
We do hope that his disappearance from the touchline does not affect their performance.
Oh, it will affect them, definitely. It always affects
FC
them.
FC wants this more than any club before, you know, looking at the home advantage.
Imagine life without your mother to tell you what to do, especially when you're still mommy's boy. Sure. That's a situation that's going to be happening at the Kacheka Stadium.
From that short break. Now, I do hope that you do have your phones or even your computers to engage in this particular conversation. Where we'll be talking relationship and, of course, trying to find out a way of helping Lucy. Now, Lucy did get in touch with us and said, "Hello, my name is Lucy. I have been in a relationship for 7 years with my current boyfriend. Unfortunately, my ex did make his return to the country and we have been secretly meeting. I find out that I do have feelings for my ex. Nevertheless, I've also found out that my current boyfriend has plans of proposing to me. I am confused because I still have feelings for my ex as well as for my new boyfriend. What should I do?" That is Lucy getting in touch with us. That was a bit of a summary that we managed to get out of this particular letter that Lucy shared with us. As you can see on our screens, it's quite a confusing situation for anyone who has been in a relationship and someone who has not gotten over their ex. Now, we did put this on our Facebook page, Urban Television, and asked you guys, what should we do to help Lucy? But before we get into that conversation, we want to, you know, have a chat amongst the three of us and find out what is the best way to help Lucy. And we do hope that by the end of this conversation, you will have known what to do and where does your heart exactly belong. Because at the end of the day, that also matters, especially if it is to do with relationship issues. Now, Tina, you have been in a long relationship. Willis and I have been in relationships. We know how these things do happen, especially if...
Are you trying to call me a veteran? Oh, I'll take that badge of honor. It's a badge of honor.
It's a badge of honor, especially in the relationship field. Lucy right there has a very disturbing kind
it's
of situation.
It's not disturbing.
Going
First of
on.
All, Lucy, you're stupid. Secondly, let me use Kebangambanga Tulibatu. Growing up, Boba akulira ku msente. Akadda nyuma nyuma.
Kakola katia.
When come out. Because, let me tell you.
Listen.
You have a perfectly ready, able-bodied man. He wants
for 7 years. They've been together for 7 years.
You get what I'm saying? For 7 years, you've had this beautiful man around you. I mean, and then women come out and say that men are trash, right? For 7 years, this guy has loved you, and now he wants to cross that.
If a woman tells you she's
quiet,
it's okay, you've been meeting only trash. Continue with your statement.
I have not met any trash.
Then why do you call them trash?
Except you.
Let us continue.
I said,
let us continue with the statement.
This is why women say all men are trash, not Tina.
But women are the trash cans.
Yes, we are diverting from the point. Let us come back to
No, I need to clarify on that. I can never say men are trash. Because I hear feminists saying those things. And I'm like, so if all men are trash, your father, your brothers, your uncles, please.
Me, every feminist who has come out to say men are trash, I always tell them, you're the trash can.
Okay.
And we are square.
Okay. So you've had this beautiful man for 7 years. He loved you enough to make you his queen in that kind of way. You get? He wants to propose to you. You've heard that he's going to propose to you. Then you want to dial it back to your ex you walked away from 7 years ago. Butai. If he was okay walking away the first time, what makes you think the second time around is going to be the charm? You get what I'm saying? That's just plain BS. It's plain BS. And let me tell you something. If anybody ever decides to get up and walk away, if anybody ever does that to you in your life, farewell, good riddance, too bad rubbish. Move on. If this what you're in is not what you want, Lucy,
and you're backtracking to your ex, then simple. Block your ex, told Daye, you could be full. No, no, Mule, can't move on in life single. Why are you damaging people? And that's you damaging an innocent soul. There is a man who readily wants you, loves you, and is ready for you. And you're dialing it back to 7 years. I mean, forget about the 2 years. 2 years, like a flame is still, eh?
Tina, but we've been in situations whereby you turn back to your ex, and it is probably the right path you will choose.
Net Dabambi.
You know?
How many people do you know who have broken up with their exes and come back and it has sustained? Longevity has been beautiful.
We have seen relationships built on breakup and makeup,
breakup and makeup. When I say breakup and makeup, there's breakup and makeup 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 months. That is understandable. That's why Wazungu call it, I need some space. I need me to reevaluate us. You get? That's why they do it.
Which
that's what
rubbish,
they call
but it's okay.
It is also rubbish. Separation. You get? Na yaka stores 365 days. Who are you? And this girl is such an idiot that the man she's going back for is not even in the country. He just came back into the country. What are the chances he has his baggage from where he has been? What are the chances he's actually come back here for some more different garbage? Because at the end of the day, a man is a man. Women, we need a reason to have sex. A man needs a place to have sex. Two different mindsets. For a man, it's where. For a woman, why? You know, it's the truth. Anyway,
yeah, I would say this.
So wait. So lastly, what is the best advice you have for Lucy? What
the
should
best
she
advice
do?
I have for Lucy? A bird in the hand is better than what?
But she has two birds in the hand.
Yes,
she someone is going to propose the ex is also back.
No, the ex is back and they have been meeting. She says they have been meeting secretly and apparently they do have feelings for each other. And particularly Lucy still has feelings for the guy, for the ex. So she literally has two bodies.
You're in trouble. You're in trouble. At the end of the day, I'm going to do that BS that white people say. Follow your heart, Lucy, and I hope you have it broken in tiny smithereens. I hope you have it incinerated to a part where
why
it asses
so
on the asses.
Why are you so pissed?
Because my exes all come back. You see, that's why I told you. I got it good like that. But at the end of the day, this is what I'm going to say. There are tons of women out there who would kill to have that kind of relationship you have with your 7 year man? You get? There are women out there. There are women who sleep binding and breaking and calling. They want a man. So my advice is, please, let him go. Family ready. We shall be here. We'll catch him.
All right.
Yeah, say there are many ways to look at it. Number one is we worry too much as people. If you look at the Bible, it talks about how it asks who is feeding the birds in the skies. You understand?
True.
We worry about things that change. We worry about things that are not permanent in life. If you talk about feelings, feelings don't last. Feelings, actually, when you call for someone.
First 3 months,
you're, oh my God, I love them. You're with them, you're calling them all the time. After 3 months, the feelings are sort of not there, but it's now the commitment, it's now the brain, it's now the mind, it's now the individual now, the real you that, you know, is consciously making effort and a decision to be with someone. So the feelings, if you're going to depend on feelings only to be with someone, the other thing is that, Why are you still talking to your ex after years?
7 years.
I mean, if someone could...
Because she says, we didn't read the whole letter. She says that this ex came back to the country and got in touch with her.
Yeah, that's
important. That means she was always cheating. That means she's a cheater. That means she's a cheater, a big, big cheater. I wish I had the number of her man right now who's supposed to propose. I'm telling you, boo, you have dodged a bullet. That's a real, real cheater.
That's
7 years.
Yeah, but you see, this is the thing. If I like to come to laugh at people who say, who are friends with their exes. If your ex left you and you claim your friends, we are good friends with my ex, I like to laugh at them very much. Because it's like having a best friend, and your best friend tells you, you know what, you've done this to me, we are no longer friends. Then after 2 weeks, they're like, but can we be friends who just talk on WhatsApp?
No, Willis,
you understand?
Willis,
this is
one
the time we all. If someone leaves you and tells you, you know what, I don't like your BS, probably because of this and this and this, we can't work out. Probably because I'm going abroad for a job. Probably because family doesn't like you. And they give you any excuse to leave you. And then later they come back to you and tell you they have feelings for you. Those are fools.
They're idiots.
You're wasting your time. They never liked you.
In the first place.
If someone walks away from your life, treat them as a stranger from there and then. If they are to build a relationship again with you, let it start again. Yeah. But let someone not come to you and tell you, I still have feelings for you on the basis of what they had.
Before.
If they did it, they can do it again.
The thing for me here, Willis, and we've had this argument a lot. Your ex is not just your ex. It depends on the breakup and what happened. Other than the breakup. Listen, no, it does, because I know you have your bias.
I believe your ex is your ex, no matter the kind of
breakup. Yes, exactly. Your ex is your ex. It's that simple. Your ex is your ex. But if they reach out to you, hey, what's up, what's good? It's your prerogative. It's your prerogative, you, the person. Who they're reaching out to. If you're in a relationship and you're like, you know what, don't even. Hi, what's good? I'm good. I'm in a relationship. You're good? Fine. Bye. Let it be. If you're in whatever situation, it is again. And how you let them come into your life. Like I told you, and I'm not afraid to say this, my exes are my friends because they are a chapter and a part of your life.
And they know
a part of me that not everybody knows.
I think we need to
if
define
I bump
friends.
In, yeah, if I bump into you, not hey, what's up? Let's hang out tomorrow. No.
Exactly. Yeah.
If we bump into each other, what's good? Once in a while, a popping text would be like, yo, I just watched you on TV. How you doing? How is life? That's okay. It is perfectly
that's
okay.
That's
how these kind of relationships of slipping with
you. No. I didn't say that be enemies with your ex, Nenda.
No.
But you need to push your ex far into the stranger's path that you just know them as someone
friend
who was
zone.
In your life. You understand? Like
friend zone your
a
exes.
High friend. You don't
high
bring
bye.
Them close.
What is so bad with getting
because
to,
one of the reasons exes
back
come
ex.
Back into your life
they feel they know
come,
you.
No, they come into your life to see how far you've gone. So
to
they can choose
after.
To either laugh at you or be sad about the fact that they left you. One of the two. So you have to leave them away and just keep them as friends who you just talk to from
you know what's interesting about me and my exes is that I even know their current wives and we just
perfectly fine, but you just keep it at that distance.
Yeah,
the other reason
distance.
Why Lucy is in such a situation is what is we are not honest as I think Ugandans. When we start relationships, we fail to define the relationships from the word go. It's very important for you and the person you're getting into a relationship with to define it and be like, okay, you know what? I want us to just have a casual thing. Like from the word go, you know that this is not going anywhere. It's just for us to meet up on a good Friday evening, have a blast, and then go back to our lives.
Yeah.
You define and be like, you know what? From the word go, you're like, yo, I want to do everything I can for this relationship to head into marriage. And from the word go, you know it. But Lucy has been with this guy for 7 years, and in her head, she was just running away from her ex.
Exactly.
Her relationship was,
He was the fall.
He was a rebound.
He was a rebound. Yes.
She should have told this guy, you know what? I've just broken up with my ex. I'm going through a lot.
Let's try to maintain here. Yeah.
And that's also a problem. This let's try and see where it heads.
It's not definitive.
It's lavish.
It's lavish.
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 If anyone ever comes and tells you, let us see where it is headed.
Go over.
Head out.
There's another thing. There's a statement. There's a statement I read somewhere, and this guy was like, I don't do girlfriend. I do wife. If you're coming into my life, girl, you better know I'm looking for a wife, not a girlfriend.
Those are
real.
And
that is what we call defining the relationship. And most people have a problem with defining the relationship. Like, I was talking to this guy, I'm like, yo, check this. I am not in any headspace to deal with emotion.
So
I can't
just,
do. So, you want bang? Let's bang. You want chill? Let's chill.
And defining the relationship is not only at the beginning of a relationship.
Or every
you can
day.
Reevaluate probably after a month.
After
you're like, yes, now
you know
I
what?
Think.
Let's just look at some Facebook
to,
response coming
twice
here.
A week.
Nimrodes comes through and says, do what your heart is telling you. Saying, don't go back to your ex, that's a trap.
It's a trap! Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, a couple of them, Musai says, watching. And then a couple of others on Twitter as well, some other people coming out to say that, move on and focus on your current relationship. You never know, that is the ring to life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's an interesting one there. And, of course, a couple of more others, I just can't read all of them, but from us personally, we believe that, Lucy,
you're
let go of your ex.
No, I think I would think, sit down, you as the chairman, have a meeting with your head and your heart.
These are just mistakes of the mind and the brain, meeting. You know?
Your mind is playing games
with you. All you need to do is understand you've been with this guy for 7 years, your ex left you, they've probably been doing whatever they've been doing with their life. They probably have happies for some reason. So please, stick to this guy, you know, build a family together.
No,
the fact
that you have thought about going back to your ex, don't stick with this guy.
Don't break
Let
this
him
man.
Be-
I haven't today. A very big thanks to everyone who has been part of the show from morning at 6:30 up to 8 is always the time that we do have selected for you. But we'll see you tomorrow. I mean, the fun never stops. Do enjoy the rest of Urban TV programming because we are big on sports and entertainment.